The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "You have heard that it was said to your ancestors, 'Do not take a false oath, but make good to the Lord all that you vow.' But I say to you, do not swear at all, not by heaven, for it is God's throne, nor by the earth, for it is his footstool, nor by Jerusalem, for it is the city of the great King. Do not swear by your head, for you cannot make a single hair white or black. Let your yes mean yes, and your no mean no. Anything more is from the evil one." My dear friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat, and once again, welcome to the Minor Basilica of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manawag. Today, we celebrate the memorial of the Immaculate Heart of Mary. What does it mean when somebody tells you your heart is in the right place? Nasa tamang lugar ang inyong puso. Or have you heard somebody telling, alam mo, stricto yan, pero her heart is in the right place? May ibig sabihin nun? Typically, ang ibig sabihin ng your heart is in the right place is that you are well-intentioned. May mabuting kalooban. May busilak na kalooban. Maganda ang intensyon sa kanyang puso. No? Kaya nga kapag narinig nyo na sinabihan kayo, alam nyo, your heart is in the right place. Magpasalamat ha, say thank you, because it's a very positive appreciation. Today, my dear friends, we give praise to God by celebrating the memorial of the Immaculate Heart of Mary. At isa sa pinaka-ebidensya na Mary's heart is in the right place is that she has our well-being in her heart. Laging yung intention niya ay sa ikabubuti natin. Kaya nga pabalik-balik kayo dito sa Manawag, ano? Kahit may mga lockdown, kahit ang hirap pumasok, no? You try your best to come back because you know that Mary's heart beats for us. It is always in her heart to bring our prayers to her son. Her heart is in the right place. Kahapon po, I met a devotee na who asked for a blessing. At nung bineblessan ko na, biglang naiyak. Akala ko tinamaan ng holy water yung kanyang mata. And then when I asked anong nangyari, ang sabi niya, kasi Father, ang tagal-tagal nang hindi kami nakabalik dito sa Manawag. And finally again, we're given the opportunity to come back. And I smiled because I told myself, here is one who continue to believe that Mary's heart is in the right place. That their intention will be at the heart of Mary's concern. Isa pa, itong memorial na sineselebrate natin ngayon ay ang ganda ng pagkakalagay ng pwesto, sapagkat ito ay inilagay pagkatapos ng celebration natin ng kapistahan, ng solemnity ng Sacred Heart of Jesus. Kahapon yon, di ba? And then today, we celebrate the memorial of the Immaculate Heart of Mary. For me, it is something that is very important. Because if we ask, bakit nga ba yung heart of Mary is always in the right place? It is because Mary's heart was fashioned according to the heart of the Sacred Heart of her Son. Kaugnay yun eh. Magkaugnay yun. Kaya nga nasa tamang lugar lagi yung puso ni Maria. Ang ganda ng paglalagay niya because it reminds us. Kaya nga, if you are wondering what gave Mary the courage to say, "I am the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to your word. Pagkatapos nasabihan siya ng anghel, oh, ikaw magdadalang tao ka, and you're going to bear the Son of God and keep Him in your womb. No? Siguro kapag kung sino man ang sabihan sa atin nandito, you're gonna freak out. Paano to? Paano mangyayari? And yet Mary had the courage to say, after that, I am the handmaid of the Lord, be it done to me according to thy word. And for what reason? Obvious. Mary's heart is fashioned according to the heart of her son, Jesus. Kaya nga, in a way, if there are times, that we remember more clearly that even our hearts are also fashioned according to the heart of Mary's son, according to the heart of Jesus. Ito yung mga pagkakataon na ang dali-dali nating tumulong. We do not question anymore, natutulong ba ako o hindi, when we put the good of other people before our own needs. When we do that, when we go out of our way, then my dear friends, my dear brothers and sisters, it tells us that our heart is in the right place and it beats in the same manner as Mary's heart's beat. We are all fashioned according to the heart of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Kaya lang at times, nagiging malabo yun. Kaya kapag ka nagkakaroon tayo ng mga pagkakataon na ang daling tumulong, ang daling mag-reach out, ang daling gumawa ng mabuti, it is a reminder to us that our heart is fashioned according to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Isa pa, sa pagkakataon sa buhay ni Maria, sa wedding at Cana, you remember that story? Nung naubusan ng alak, and then Mary went to Jesus, and then Mary said, anak, wala na silang alak. And then Jesus' answer was not very promising, because Jesus said, what does it concern me, woman? It's not yet my time. Alak yan. No? But Mary did not stop. She went on. She went to the servant and then told the servant, do whatever he tells you to do. Gawin mo kung anong pinagagawa niya. Ako bahala dito. You know why? Because Mary knows the heart of her son. Hindi niya matitiis yung sitwasyon. In a way, what Mary told the servant in the gospel was also her instruction to all of us. Do whatever he tells you to do. Kaya nga kapag maraming pagkakataon na yung dasal natin, yung mga hinihiling natin, ay hindi kaagad-agad ipinagkakaloob, it is actually reminding us, persist, go on, continue. Because sinasabi ni Maria, kilala ko yung puso ng aking anak. Hindi niya kayo matitiis. Basta, do whatever he tells you to do. Yun lang naman yung caveat doon eh. Yun lang naman yung requirement doon. No? Just go ahead. No? Woman, what does it concern you? Hindi pinakinggan ni Maria. She went to the servant. Do whatever she tells you to do. In our case, maraming dasal. Minsan, akala natin hindi na pagbibigyan. Maraming inihahain at iniaakyat sa Panginoon. Akala natin ini-ignore. But Mary is telling us, alam ko at kilala ko yung puso ng aking anak. Do whatever he tells you to do. Miracles happen. Lastly, isa pa sa napakaganda sa puso ni Maria is that Mary knows what to treasure and what to ponder in her hearts. Marami sa mga sinabi sa kanya ng anghel ang hindi immediately naging malinaw sa kanya. Marami sa mga sinabi sa kanya ng Panginoon ang hindi gaano naging malinaw from the start. But Mary's heart has this characteristic of taking it, and she knows that if it is from God, it must be something very important, and she pondered on this promise again and again and again. Mary knows what to put in her heart, what to keep, and what to ponder. Because what she kept and what she pondered, the promise of God, na hindi kita iiwan, hindi kita pababayaan, It was what sustained her when she was face to face with her son suffering, when she was at the foot of the cross. It sustained her. It continued to give her strength na hindi ka pababayaan ng Panginoon. My dear friends, the same way, it asks us the question, what do we keep in our hearts? Ano ba yung mga nasa puso ninyo sa ngayon? No? Will it sustain us in our faith? Will it help us, particularly in this difficult time? Will it give us strength? Will it inspire us to continue despite of the difficulties? Because if not, Mary is asking us the question, what's the most important in our hearts? My dear friends, today, as we celebrate the memorial of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, she is also asking us this question. Is your heart in the right place?